see this from the top, make sure I don't ruin it again. Because I've started recording this like 1,500 times already. And it's gotten really annoying. Alright, let's just get straight to it. 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Providing his signature transformation in this depiction, Tweety has giant feet with sharp claws, no feathers on his wings, which expose bone and hint at mange, wide
red eyes,
sharp teeth,
easy way to tell that your bed is awful.
And an even sharper beak,
let me prove
and straggly eyelashes, as opposed to his usual adorable ones. Even with all these features, you can still see the innocent Tweety somewhere in the wreckage, which is a unique mark of Dennis Carlson's work. Number 9, Leonardo.
When it comes to mattresses, you used to only have 3 choices. Looking for some shoulder pain? Try a hard mattress. Oh, it may feel like a rock and put pressure on your hips, but it's the perfect way to tell your partner, hey baby, want some arthritis? It just fails the raw egg test.
We're raised in the spheres and taught the art of ninjutsu. In this artwork, Leonardo,
then there's the soft mattress. Starts out okay, but collapses over time, like some cheap sneakers or Anakin Skywalker. And since it comes with soft mattress, we're here to try cool new hobbies, like chronic pain. But it also failed the raw egg test.
Leo's eyes are red and intensify his harsh expression.
Now let me explain the eggs. The raw egg test states that the perfect bed will let you put weight on raw eggs without breaking them. Because if a bed can cradle raw eggs while supporting all that weight, it'll also cradle your pressure points while supporting your body for maximum comfort. Well, if the hard bed's bad at cradling, and the soft bed...
Lilo and Stitch is an animated Disney film in which a lonely girl obtains an alien as a friend in the film, and years after, Stitch is known for being an adorable ball of fur with wide, precious eyes and a silly personality. In the depiction created by Dennis, he actually isn't much different. His ears are covered with holes, and his smile shows a set of needle-like teeth covered in scarlet. Overall, Stitch is still a small, fluffy creature with adorable eyes. The fact that he is holding a human leg, in which he has taken a bite of, does change the tone, though. His long claws grasp the detached leg as he stares forward at the audience. Number 7, Pooh Bear.
Congratulations, Pooh! You win the grand prize!
Always after some delicious honey, who adventures through life with his friends. In July 2016, Dennis shared a different side of Pooh in this digital painting. The little cuddle bear stares forward with an intense expression. Wrinkles surround his bright red eyes. His abnormally wide mouth exposes sharp yellow and detailed teeth. Pooh's hand is covered in a red substance, which he pulls from a jar labeled honey. Clearly, the substance dripping from his paw is not your average honey. His signature red shirt is torn and dirty. In this creation, Pooh gives off a general vibe of stay away from me and whatever is in this jar. This image is another of Dennis's most popular with nearly 11,000 likes. Number 6, Minion. The Minions made their debut in 2010, when the first Despicable Me film was released. Most children are easily obsessed with the Minions, and even some adults find them adorable. So obviously, with such a weird obsession, the Minions are constantly being remastered or edited in fan art. Dennis Carlson gave it a shot in July 2016, with this truly monstrous adaptation of a Minion, sporting a usual Minion uniform and holding a banana. This little guy doesn't look too bad at first, however it doesn't take long to notice the coarse skin, sharp teeth, glowing red eye, and distorted body proportions. Actually, this Minion looks much more like the servant to a villain than the original creations do. Number 5, Quasimodo. The Hunchback of Notre Dame was written by Victor Hugo in 1831. The classic tale follows an outcast named Quasimodo with a hunchback that lives in a cathedral. Dennis created a digital painting of Quasi, which took nearly 3 hours. This appearance is even more unsettling than the original. Quasi has speckled, wrinkled, and acne-prone skin. His eyes are red and glazed over, as if from age. His severe overbite exposes sparse yellow and crooked teeth. Overall, poor Quasi is a detailed and grotesque work of art. The strangely sad part is that despite this even worse depiction, Quasi still has a gentle expression which makes you feel sorry for him. Though Dennis has uploaded speed paintings of almost all of his work, this video on Quasimodo is absolutely fascinating. Every little detail in Quasi's skin is shown in the footage. A link to the full video will be in the description. Number 4, Mickey Mouse.
You like Mickey Mouse?
Yeah. Well, Mickey Mouse is about to be ruined, eliminated.
The first character from the mind of Walt Disney first hit the screen in November 1928 and has since become the mascot for the Disney franchise. When it comes to fan art, Mickey is a common character that is recreated in various ways. However, the way Dennis reimagined this friendly mouse is unlike most. Mickey is usually a smiling, dancing, and overall sporting friend of all. In this creative remake, though, he is the exact opposite. He has sharp, rotten teeth, giant claws, wide-open red eyes, and bubbly, rough skin. He also has a bite out of one of his ears, and his clothes and fur is tattered all over. Basically, this Mickey looks as though he's ridden with mange or rabies and is ready to hunt his beloved fans. Number 3, Sully. The ironic thing about this artwork is that Dennis took a monster and made it even more monstrous. Monsters, Inc. is a 2001 Disney film and instant classic. Being a Disney movie, the monster depictions are not bad at all. In fact, Sully, who is the best monster in the factory, is just a big fluffy teddy bear, which even attracts him the name Kitty. Dennis knows the true form of a monster and recreated Sully in October 2016. In his masterpiece, Silly has long horns which slightly curl above his head. His eyes are glowing red. He has a massive mouth with teeth all pulled together with a threatening expression and growl. This monster is far from a kitty and really embodies what it means to be a monster. Number 2, Totoro. My Neighbor Totoro is one of the many masterful creations by Ghibli Studios. Released in 1988, the film follows two young girls as they adventure with the spirit of the forest, Totoro, a large fluffy hamster-like creature that can fly. The light-hearted plot and magical artwork brings this film to life and has attracted fans for decades now. Of course, there's been rumored lore that Totoro was actually the god of the afterlife, which gave this film a dark undertone. For those that rewatched it after reading the rumors, with this unpleasant story in mind, the transformation created by Dennis is even more upsetting. In this creation, Totoro has inflamed and infected skin in several places, including around his eyes and on his lower body. His bright red eyes bulge out of his face, and his giant teeth protrude out of his mouth. He also has what looks like a boil near his belly, and strings of unidentified yellow goop stretching from the ground. This speed painting video is also another great one in the many uploads by Dennis Carlson. Before we get to number one, my name is Chills, and I hope you're enjoying the video so far. If you've ever been curious as to what I look like in real life, then follow me on Instagram at DylanIsChillinYT with underscores instead of spaces. I also have a Twitter at YT_Chills where I post video updates. Everyone born after 1995 can probably scream this theme song at the top of their lungs. SpongeBob SquarePants, a living sponge that lives in a pineapple under the sea, is the absolute epitome of innocence, ignorance, eagerness, and kindness. In fact, SpongeBob is so kind and ignorant that he doesn't even know his neighbor loathes him. Through silly adventures and subliminal life lessons, SpongeBob has a special place in the heart of many kids, teens, and even adults. He has even marked his territory when it comes to memes. It seems like every year there's a new SpongeBob meme that is better than the last, and with such simple character design, he's another great example for artists to recreate. Dennis Carlson probably wins the award for most upsetting SpongeBob recreation, though. The artwork is a masterpiece, but seeing the beloved sponge in such a gross state almost makes fans a little sad. SpongeBob seems to be made out of actual sea sponge, which gives him a coarse body that is aesthetically unappealing. His large eyes are red and glazed as they bulge out of his head towards the viewer. He basically doesn't have lips, so his rotten teeth and raw gums are visible. To tie everything together, SpongeBob has pink tentacles sprouting out of his body in every location. Though SpongeBob's innocence was completely ruined in this creation, it's still a masterpiece that shows a unique and magnificent view of a beloved character. Links to both Dennis Carlson's Instagram and YouTube are
okay, that is the video, guys.
Thanks for checking out this video.
Like it.
Be sure to subscribe because we have new countdowns every Tuesday and Saturday. If you're still not convinced, here are some of the other videos that I think you'd like.
Top 15.
Take him in the room.
Alright.
We falling asleep, bro.
Alright, guys. Peace out.
Stand up.